Hey, yo, together, and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays on Belshire Vestige today, Leather Edition, Void Edition, with another TVC, as we have spawning in the bottom right hand side, in the red, as the Zerg, it is their Hive Mind. And in the top left hand side, the Blue Terran. For Pro Kings, it's me, Alex Usher. So this game will be quite interesting. Not sure how much you can get out of this game, like for personal studies or learning, but there are some interesting approaches to this game, this matchup I mean, which can be somewhat entertaining. So we will see, we will see. Hatch first, and here Rex gas on my side, which is totally fine, I would say. And the rest can be okay, I mean, we'll see. We will definitely see how this goes. So after this game I need to play two StarCraft 2 unranks in order to fill the next 3 weeks coming up. And I haven't played much lately, so this will definitely be a disaster. But I will try my best just to get this out of the way as well. It's not that that's something I need to do. I still want to do it. I still want to play StarCraft 2. But currently my focus is a little bit shifted away from StarCraft 2. I didn't watch DreamHack Austin as well, like at all. I didn't watch it. I am watching somewhat GSL, but not enough, and SSL I'm missing quite a lot because it's on YouTube instead of Twitch, and therefore, yeah, I'm just missing it out a little bit. So it looks like I'm going for the 2-on-1 here with the Reaper again. And the Hive Mind looks like he's going for a standard build himself as well, with the third base coming up really early, if it's... Yeah, it looks like. Oh yeah, okay, it makes... no, 4 Zerglings instead of 6. I get 1 Zergling, not too bad. Will I get this drone? That's the big question. Oh, I get the drone as well, that's huge! Okay, nice. And maybe 1 more Zergling? Maybe not. Okay, ooh, that was close. Hot dance with this Reaper, but already paid for itself. Didn't scout the main, which is problematic. Didn't quite scout the third base, which is also problematic, but at least I got some damage. Uh-oh. Woo! That was close. So now I will get the... No, come on, you need to scout. I can't be that stupid. Well, okay, I can. Turns out I can be that stupid and just not scout at all. So speedlings on the way, and they could kill a mule also quite fast. So now I do scout. Maybe I get another drone, that would be so nice. Uh-oh. And the Reaper goes in. Oh, that's a nice scout. So here the Zerglings attacking this depot while the Reaper escapes, as it looks like. No damage at all. Oh, that's bad. So I did scout the hatchery. I don't know if I can read into this, because it's the hatchery is morphing into a lair before the third base is finished. So interesting. But we need to just see what's happening here. I can't be sure. So here we go. More units. I think this is too early with the Hellions. It's not lining up perfectly with the Medivacs to go up to 16 Marines. I wonder what the Hive Mind is doing. Spire, really early Spire. Nice creep spread starting into all directions, the main as well as down to the third base. A little bit lacking here, but that's fine. Can be fixed. Good scouting with this Overlord. He doesn't see anything, that's bad. But he can assume that something is happening. Yeah, look at that. There are 3 Marines missing. That's not good. Can he defend? Look at that. He is assuming that I'm going for this build. So that's why he has those units right now, right there, at this minute mark. I could also drop here, just go and kill everything. Counter strategy, you know. So, uh-oh. Here we go. Ah, is this working out? Looks like the Hellions morphing just now into Hellbats. But, oh, the wraparound is huge. I lost quite some units here in the process. But so far, it seems like I can deal at least some damage. Maybe not enough. Nope, not enough damage. That was okay, but not beautiful. The dream would have been to crush everything here and then attack the hatchery, bring it to half-life, or even kill it. So now he is pooping on my potential third bases. And behind it, going for Mutalisk himself, the transition is almost done. At least for the 5 racks, not the 8 racks. Income wise, I'm ahead in worker, that's awesome. So those Mutalisks need to deal some damage. Otherwise, it's looking quite bad for him. Yeah, upgrades need to come up as well. Where are my upgrades? Oh, just starting soon. Oh no, I don't have enough gases. Huge mistake! That's not good. That's the workers right here. Oh no. So how many Mutalisks are there? 5. That's not enough. 5, 6. Oh, this drop is awesome. He needs to cancel this. Cancel! No, cancel! The hive mind, what have you done? 300 minerals. Flush down the toilet. Oh, that's some nice pickup now. Because now I'm losing 300 minerals and 100 gas for nothing. That was stupid. So against Zerg, I would say it makes more sense to keep the boost to boost out against Mutalisk at least, instead of boosting into the main base. So this Overlord dies. Wow, huge counterattack coming. Look at my macro, it's so bad. I could be way more ahead, but I'm not. Uh oh. I don't know if I can hold this. This is not looking too good. But the Zerglings are a little bit undecisive with their attack. The Widowmine doesn't connect at all. There is one turret. He's donating some Mutalisks. Interestingly, I think I didn't take too much damage. It should be fine. Double cancel here, that's okay, but he's denying my third base. Look how low eco this game is, unbelievable. We are on the same amount of worker, so this should favor me. The upgrades are similar. He's going for burrow. Okay, evolved burrow. With that upgrade he can lay some nice banding bombs. Or mines, and they can detonate like crazy. So finally I can go grab my base here. Some idle worker. I need to fire up 2-2 ASAP. Like he is doing his 2-2 upgrades as well, I guess. Come on, 2-2! 2-2! Both! No, he's going for 13 Banelings. Okay, if you only have one, I would do this. Now my upgrade is coming in, but the second one is missing. Why? Why? At least I'm getting a bunker and a turret, and I have a Widowmine, so that's nice. Uh-oh! Oh, last second burrow. Okay. There we go, 2-2, finally on the way. Creep spread should be better now. Baneling counter attack. Oh no. I do see this. And another double drop this time. Denied. Cancelled, yep. But this drop is so dead. With 2 medivacs with full marines, this could have worked, but otherwise, nope. The medivac will just die, probably. And there we go, counterattack. I saw it. Is this enough? How will the splits be? Oh, now he revealed that he has burrow towards me. He's so far behind in... Come on, supply! I don't know how this is working. Oh, that was bad. Ooh, but yeah, my fourth base is super late. He's still on three bases, which is not good at all for Zerg. I denied this base over and over again. But still, he's hanging in there. I am heavily supply capped for a long time now. Which look at my bank. That's because I don't macro up. And it looks like we got a huge attack coming on. Should stop talking. But without talking, there's no casting. There's a big attack coming in. A huge flank from the... Oh, wow. All the Mutalists die. But it looks like the wraparound with the Zerglings is enough. And he just hits with his 2-1 against my 1-1. And he can clear all the Widowmines now. That's good. Needs to retreat, maybe. Ooh. Wow, wasted. Oh, the Widowmine. Oh, so close. Can I defend? I think I can. Somehow he's losing so many Zerglings. At least he snagged that Widowmine, but oh, the Mutalisk! Okay. Finally his fourth base is coming up. Oh, losing one Mutalisk there. That's sad. And he's going for Infestor, and he has Quetzal. That's why he went for Burrow as well. If Burrowed Infestors as well as Baneling Mines can work so good in this matchup nowadays. Looks like we got a double drop. And then some counterattack on the left hand side. Okay, he has both bases taken now. So this should lead into at least some economic advantage. Depending on which base he can saturate and hold. But we will see. Oh, he could have fungled those units, but now it's too late. This base under attack again. Baneling mines. Yeah, not doing too much here, the Banelings, I mean. The Widowmine as well. 2-2 against. 2-2. So this fight, I do win. Oh, good fungal. Will it be enough? Random scan. This Infestor is not even burrowed. And we do escape. Can I rescue this Marauder? Oh, wasting so many units here. Huh. At least this base survived. Wow, so many. Almost only Marines and Zerglings died in this game. You could think this is a mono battle game, a card game, but it's not. And he's kept on 118. That's not good. Depending on the situation, I would say this is the last push, but it can go horribly wrong as well. His mining is still solid. If only he can hold on. Queens are coming, Mutalists are coming, where's the reinforcements? There are the Banelings. Good fungals. But will it be enough? Plenty of energy on those Infestors. I think he can barely hold, maybe? Another scan. Another fungal. I don't know. No, it's looking like I can just barely overwhelm him. In the meantime, I took this base with the planetary portals as well. It's looking good for me. He still has this base upcoming. Oh, I don't know if you can go into Hive now. Do you have really the income to go into Hive? That's questionable. Oh, those larva die. Dead. So let's see what we can do here. What's happening? 3-3 finishing up now, and that's my advantage. Now, at least now, I should have the upper hand. It still could go horribly wrong. Don't get me wrong here. I mean, if the Banelings hit with the fungals or he has some Baneling mines, that can work really nicely into his hands. But overall, I would say that's looking really good for me. 13 Widowmines. 5 Zerglings, that's nothing. He doesn't have any army left. And there's some Greater Spire coming up, which is okay. But is it really enough? The spread is decent, I would say. Oh, the Widow Mines! Oh no, the Widow Mines! No! That's game, come on. This has to be game. You just lost all your Mutalisks to this beautiful... Oh wow, Ghost now as well on the field. Really good against... Yeah, basically anything. Against Ultralisks, they can be decent against Great Aspire as well. That snipe was a little bit weird. They are awesome against Infestor. You can snipe them or you can just EMP those. Both can work beautifully and I'm so far ahead. Can I potentially throw it? Yes, I can. But it's not very likely to happen. Oh, here I'm heavily oversaturated. Ah, he can't build there, look at that. No, he is so dead. He has some mining left, but not much. It's interesting how I played this, how I played this game. Like, left, right punches all game long. Some counter drops with the, but they didn't do anything. But overall, I just did tear him apart while constantly killing his potential fourth base. He never really mined out of one of these those bases. Never. Ah, the fungus could be huge. Whoa! But the healing power from the Medivax is just too much. There are some Broodlords now, 5 in total. They could be the game changer. Ah, only one snipe gets off. Oh, and the fungals. It really could work. Look, oh, that was a big chunk of my army. Some marines underneath the Broodlords. But it's not enough, they all go down. And even though his last attack was really good, that's it. GG, well played. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions? Put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.